Greetings. You know, when it comes to America and the homeless problem, you know, there's a lot of dynamics to it, but you ask yourself, how does someone end up being the person who's dropping trowel and dropping a deuce on the streets? That's not a matter of money or, you know, homelessness. That's a matter of insanity. But you ask yourself, how does that come to that? Well, I've lived all sorts of different weird ways. Between 4 years, I lived in the woods. Buddy's dad had land. I rented it for $100, built a yurt. You know, life was really chill. And the years I was moving garbage for a living to pay off the house I'm currently showing you right here, living in this remodel I'm doing, I moved garbage and I lived in vehicles. So I've been kind of homeless adjacent. And when I drove truck for 8 to 10 years, somewhere in that range, don't really know. If I wasn't driving truck, I would be partying in my van out there, you know, just go find a place, go fishing, go do whatever. So I've always kind of been in between worlds of sorts. You know, it's funny, I paid off a house before most people even had a loan going on. So, you know, what I did worked. But it's not really popular. So I just kind of want to go over what I've noticed. And like, I'm going to say this, a lot of what you see, the real craziness going on in the cities, it's not really a matter of the money or the homelessness, because people with a mind can work their way out of something. But once you're insane, yeah, crapping on the streets probably shows you're insane. I'm going to explain why some of the tactics I had back in the day. By the way, freedom, feel like and subscribe. Let's get into it. Okay, so way back in the day when I was living in the woods, my yurt and whatnot, you know, you could get a shower pallet, set it up, and just take out like a little whore bath in the woods if you needed to. And much like a similar tactic I use even in the cities is that as long as you're not showing, you know, your genitals or your butt crack, you can show the crack, you just can't show the anus legally. Like, so you're wearing a pair of shorts like this. There's nothing illegal about this. You can wash the rest of your body. So if you really had to, you just, when you go use the bathroom, like say you're going to go buy a can of malt liquor or something, or buy some food or something, you just pack in a pack of, you know, like wet wipes or, you know, like get some paper towels, wet them down, and then use some, what do you call that, hand sanitizer, you know, the 70% alcohol, whatever it is, and then wash your naughty parts. And then after you're done using the bathroom, you're 100% clean, you know, unlike most people who just smear the nasty stuff. This is why I actually am a big proponent of bidets, you know, like the things where you wash your butt crack, you know, which I know, a little weird, but the French came up with a great idea with that. So the reality is that when you see some of these people that are dropping trowel on the streets, you know, they say, well, these people don't have any money for food or anything, and discrimination when they go to use the bathrooms. And there is some truth to that, somewhat. Like, a lot of these people that are on the streets, they get EBT, which is basically food stamps, but it's the modern version where you have a card. And yeah, so they could go there. And like the techniques as far as that, when I used to be a garbage man, when I was paying off this place, I would, you know, in the mornings, here's how I'd park. I'd take my vehicle, my van or whatever, and I just pick a dark spot. I show up right after dark, catch my Z's, and I'd leave before the sun rose. And then before I go to work, I go to one of the local grocery stores. You know, I was going to go buy my food there anyway, some bagels and some fruit or vegetables or whatever I was eating when I was driving, you know. And then I'd use the bathroom while I was there, and then I just do that. And then I just go to work. And then as far as showering, we had these pay showers in the marina where you could just go in there and between the hours of, I think it was 6 to 8 o'clock at night, you could go there, pop in a quarter, and you know, get all wet, and then you know, the rinse, pop in a quarter, and get all rinsed. And you know what's funny about it is I came back years later, and much like they did in the hometown that I grew up in, that's land of the dead called Port Angeles, they locked down the marina. So unless you had the code, you couldn't get in to get a shower, which that's part of the reason I developed the whole thing of like, you know, you can bathe in public as long as you're not showing the naughty parts. And hey, if people don't like that someone's doing that, well, maybe don't make it such of a pain in the ass for people to get washed up. And there is a certain level of sanity that, you know, you take away from people when day after day they smell like, you know, armpits and ass. And then good luck for that person getting a job. So you do see this kind of thing where people that could otherwise get out of what they consider to be homeless, like I'm a van lifer, I'm a drifter of natural sorts, I'm a truck driver drifter. So for me, the weirdness is just part of my existence. But most people do not have the fortitude to handle weirdness of the magnitude. And especially when you have these people that live in the cities in tents and stuff, like tent cities and crap like that. Eventually, once you've been down out long enough, that just becomes the norm. And if you smell like pits and ass on a regular basis, eventually maybe you're drinking or doing drugs to avoid, you know, just feeling anything. To feel better, you feel nothing. And then maybe you feel a little better because you're high as a kite. And some of these people fry their brains. Next thing you know, they're some crazy bag lady or some, you know, like the example of the cat lady on The Simpsons meets the dog guy on The Simpsons. You know, like she's throwing the cats and he's throwing the dogs. But that does happen to people. And sad it is, but like I said, when they're dropping trowel in the streets, one, maybe it's because there's no bathrooms that are open. Maybe the local businesses know that if these homeless people in there, sometimes you'll have the homeless people who basically they go into the bathroom just to do drugs, or they pass out, or they just never leave the toilet. I mean, look, when I was truck driving, you'd see the case where I used to punk on these people when they'd be doing it too. But now I'm not saying this to be a dick. Would you have the guy, the foreign guy? That would basically turn the large bathroom, you know, the disabled bathroom stall into his own personal office. He'd be like, blah, 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 blah. And I'd be like, oh, yeah. I'd be fake like I was on the phone. Oh, yeah, Joe. Yeah, there's some foreign guy using the crapper as his personal office, making sure that the loud enough to where his phone would catch it. You know, so the people he's talking, you know, he's on the shitter. But it's like, dude, seriously, have some class. You drop a deuce, move on, you know. But when you have people who literally camp on the toilet like that, eventually, like if it's a public bathroom, people get sick of that. And then you have the case where whether it's, you know, teenage kids destroying crap or, you know, homeless people like literally taking their dirty toilet paper and just wiping it on the walls. Maybe even like wiping some sort of message on the walls. Nobody wants to see that. So part of the thing with the contention between the homeless and the regular folk is that let's say you bought a house in an area and it was a nice place when you bought it 30 years ago and you've taken care of your house. But hey, right down the hill or right in the neighboring lot, they've built a homeless camp. And now your property value is shit because, you know, between all the crazy rambling, the dog lady and the cat lady, or, you know what I mean. You have the situation where there's friggin' needles around. You got kids, you got normal kids running around and then there's junkies, needles lying all over the place. It's just a bad image. And you have it. And then the crime inevitably goes up because of minor issues. And some of these people, once again, they can't function in normal society. So, you know, between screaming at, you know, Elvis or the Coke machine, I remember the guy at the Coke machine, that was hilarious. He looked like Weird Al Yankovic, 1980s with the afro and the glasses, wearing a tan trench coat. And he was just looking dead in the eye of that Coke machine saying, I know you're watching me, government, since 1976, blah, 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 blah. You're after me. You're watching me the whole time. You're always watching me. This is before drones and cameras were a normal thing everywhere. And I'm sitting there in my battle van, you know, this giant GMC value van with a wood stove and all the good stuff, basically an apartment on wheels. I'm sitting there eating a bagel, watching this guy. And I'm like, I know I'm a little nuts, but I'm not that nuts. Good to know I'm sane. But yeah, that guy, he's not getting a job. So you come down to, what do you do with this case? Do you throw him in nut houses? Well, we used to do that. And what happened was they had a court case back in the 80s that said it was unconstitutional to throw people in asylums for their whole life if they're only somewhat insane, you know. And now with the modern pills and stuff, and it's still questionable whether these pills are good. Sometimes they're a really good thing, but other cases, some people, they just turn them into fucking zombies and shit. And then if they try to get off of the pills, they end up having like crazy suicidal thoughts or psychotic thoughts because the mind's just reeling from what's going on chemically. But things have gotten better. But some people, they just don't want to take the pills. So they're nuts on the street. So after they were kicked out of the asylums, they were on the streets. So that's where you had a problem that the people that were nuts would inevitably end up having some issue with the cops and they get thrown in jail. And, you know, just like 10 years ago, I think the figure was from, it was like 50 to 60,000 back then to incarcerate one person. So the answer that they've slowly come up with in some states is like, look, if we get these people into a sliver apartment, you know, like a little tiny apartment, or give them enough money, maybe they live with a relative. Like I got three buddies who faked crazy because they get about $1,000 a month or more. You know, when you add up all the benefits, it's probably more like $1,100 to $1,200. And, you know, they fake crazy. So they found out they could give, like, they could just take $10,000, maybe $10,000 to $12,000 a year for each one of these people, give them a small apartment. And it was cheaper than having these people inevitably, when these people can't function, they're not really a threat. So they're not actually violent or anything like that, but they can't hold a job. So they're going to end up doing something stupid. And then we're going to have to pay even more to put them in prison. So that's also where you see now the grifters that, you know, like buddies of mine who faked crazy. And so what I'm getting at with that is that, yeah, a lot of the time the person crapping on the streets, that's a mental issue, hands down, mental issue, because there are structural ways like that you can get out of poverty if you really want to. Like, and I've said a million times, say it again, like drive truck, just get your CDL. If you have a clean driving record, just go get a CDL. I mean, if you're dirt poor, for God's sakes, never been better time to do it, because when you're that poor, generally there's some sort of government support that wants to get you off of the streets and off of the system. So they'll help you get your license for free, versus the average Joe, well, they're going to have to pay like $3,000 to $5,000 or more just to get their license. And sometimes, you know, it's like when you go to these companies and they're like, well, if you drive for us for 6 months or a year, we'll waive all the fees that you owe us. You know, and, you know, that's where you see people working for CR England or Swift or some other crap like that. But arguably, if you're so dirt poor that you're homeless, you know, wild thought there, and you're not completely tone deaf insane and you can, you know, not smoke pot. Like, look, I know it sucks, but, you know, you don't smoke pot and you just go out and you have a good old time, you know, being a, you know, truck driver. After, you know, 2, 3, 4, 5 years, you know, depending on where you want to live, just go buy a cheap piece of land, you know, live as cheap as possible in the truck, and, you know, build yourself a tiny home. And instead of being some homeless scruffer on the streets living in a fucking tent, you know, wishing things would get better, you could actually make it better. And not to say I haven't seen people who live out of tents who actually have their act together to some degree. Like, look, I lived out of a van for years. And still, I'll tell you the truth, I prefer to live out of a van versus living in a house, because I don't need this much space. And most of the fun is everywhere else I go. But you'll see these people that live in the cities, and basically they're living either out of an RV or they're living out of a tent somewhere, but they have a job doing something and they're just stacking cash. So that's a person who's strategically unhomed. They're not like some homeless person that's wearing their underwear on the outside talking to Elvis or screaming at the Coke machine. But yeah, I really think, oh yeah, there's a little side story here too. The situation where you see some of these people crapping on the streets, there used to be a technique, and I'll just close the story with this, where back in the day, plastic bags were readily available and everywhere. Now in some states, you actually have to pay a few cents for it. So it's really kind of angering if you're a person that normally used those back in the day. You know, like how you use the dog pots? Yes, this is going to get that gross. Between newspaper that used to be pretty much free, like someone gets a newspaper and then everybody reads it, and then what do you do with it? Well, lay the newspaper on the ground and then drop trowel, take a shit on it, and then basically use the bag over your hand, use the toilet paper, assuming you have any. I mean, if you're really that broke ass poor, you probably don't have toilet paper. Maybe you do. Maybe you got some at the homeless shelter. And then basically take the bag like a dog pot after you're done wiping, because you use bag over your hand to keep any shit from getting on your hands. And then you take it all and wrap it up like a dog pot and throw it in the dumpster. That's something people that have been out on the fringes have done for years. But arguably, about the same time that you started seeing people crapping on the streets more is about the same time that California banned the plastic bags. So the person that was already on the edge that now has to pay 15 or 25 cents a bag because, you know, California has a being its bonnet over plastic bags, is now someone who's really pissed. And, you know, when you're getting hassled by the cops on a regular basis, you got to move along, you got to do this. Like, you're not even hurting anybody. You're just sitting there taking a nap, and you and your dog and your friends that are all also homeless taking a nap in a public park. And then the cops show up and say, you're being a nuisance, blah, blah, blah. And it's like, no, I'm just not attractive enough. I'm not the clientele you want to see there. And we argue about it, you know, that it could be said that a lot of society is really just set up for consumerism, if we're being honest. Like, the bathrooms are only left open as long as it seems like people are shopping, you know, even the public bathrooms. And after a certain hour, you know, between the kids, they're going to destroy them with graffiti and all the other crap, and, you know, crazy people that wipe their shit on the walls. They just make it uncomfortable to the point where, you know, people are pissed off and people are insane and they're not taking their pills, so they just drop trowel shit in the streets. So I've said a lot about this, talked a lot about it, and I really think, more like I said, it's mostly mental issues and people that have fallen through the cracks and people that might have been able to be saved, but after enough drugs and enough alcohol, the answer for them is just, you know, continued insanity. So anyways, it's Freedom Phil. Like and subscribe. It's a long ramble rant, but that's my kind of thoughts on the homeless issues in America. Take it easy.